Good evening. Tonight, we will speak about real estate in Thailand. My proposition is that Thailand is the freest country for foreign property ownership or foreign real estate ownership. Really, it is freest in the world. There may be some other countries, but I cannot think of it. So far as I'm concerned, I think Thailand is the freest country. And right now, our government is proposing to have a new regulation saying that for condominium or owner-occupied apartments, foreigners can own up to 75% of the total units in each condominium. Formerly or presently, it is 49%. So they will increase the share to 75%. This is still in the process of the administration. In addition, in Thailand, we are proposing to have land lease for up to 99 years. Up to 99 years. Currently, we can buy or we can lease land for 30 years. And in the case of for industrial and industrial and commercial uses, we can lease land up to 50 years maximum. But our government now is trying to propose to have a lease for 99 years. And lease, everyone can lease, foreigners or local people, they can lease. So this is a term of 99 years. It is similar to the case of Hong Kong, where United Kingdom leased Hong Kong from China for 99 years. And then it returned to China in, say, 1994 or something. So this is a proposal. So right now, I can say that Thailand is the most freest, we call the freest, or the most free. So it should be freest country for foreign ownership of real estate. Currently, foreigners can buy land. Say if you bring in the amount of money of 40 million baht, 40 million baht may be around 1.2 million US dollar. You can buy land for your own residence, say, for one right of land. One right of land is around 1,600 square meters. 1,600 square meter. This is the size of the land you can buy if you bring in 1.2 million US dollar or 40 million baht, equivalent to 40 million baht. 1,600 square meters is around 17,000 square feet. So it is quite sizable for you to build your house. Secondly, you can buy land in industrial estate. In any industrial estate, you can buy land there. In the past, we can buy land in industrial estate only in the zone of export processing zone. But right now, in any real estate, in any industrial estate, you can buy land. So this is free for you. In addition, you can also buy condominium up to 49% of the units or of the total space. Say if the total space is 10,000 square meters, you can buy land up to, you can buy condominium up to 4,900 square meters. so 49%. And you can, but if in the case of the Eastern Economic Corridor, you can buy condominium up to 100%. Amazing indeed. In addition, you can also lease land. Say you can lease land up to 30 years normally. Like my office buildings here, I lease land for 30 years to build my office buildings, 8 stories, around 12,000 square meters, or around 14,000 square, 140,000 square feet. And we lease the rest for authors. So we lease for 30 years. But I can lease up to 50 years. I think 30 years should be okay. So I just lease 30 years. But the government is now proposing that you can lease land up to 99 years. So let us explore which country you can lease land up to 99 years. In Singapore, you can lease land up to 99 years or 999 years. However, this is in theory only. But the Urban Redevelopment Authority can lease you land for building and office buildings or something. Normally, it is around 60 years. So it is not in theory 99 years. Or even if it is 99 years just in a small piece of land, because Singapore is really small, say a tiny country, and they just subdivide lots for building something, that is for the Urban Redevelopment Authorities. In the case of Vietnam, China, Cambodia, you can lease land up to 50 years. For Chinese people and their fellow countrymen, they can lease 70 years. But if you are foreigners, the maximum will be 30 years. Normally it can be 30 or 40 years. Maximum is 50 years. Cambodia, Vietnam also the same. I went to conduct valuation of industrial estates or factories in Vietnam. Some of them, you can lease land up to 70 years. 70. But only in the special economic zones, that is industrial estates. But normally cannot. So normally it should be 50 years. But Thailand is proposing for 99 years. And if you lease land or lease apartments in China, you have to stay there, say 1 or 2 years, as a residence. If you are not residents, you cannot buy any real estate or condominiums. What about in the case of Laos, Indonesia, the period for lease is around 30 years, 25 to 30 years. Say if you want to do some agricultural farms or something, it should be 25 or 30 years. In Indonesia also around 30 years. So this is what happened to these countries. But so many people like to invest in Vietnam, Indonesia, that may be something better than the offer of land for lease or for sales, right? And in this case, on the contrary, if Myanmar allow you to lease land up to 200 years, Thailand is proposing for 99 years, right? But if Myanmar proposed to you 200 years, will you lease land there? Will you? Normally, people won't do that. Myanmar is a really great country. I love Myanmar. However, these days, not many people like to invest there because of the politics. I also went to Myanmar to conduct valuation of properties in Myanmar, particularly those industrial estates. And we found that so many industrial developments are down now. because they pull back to their own country. They may not like the government or something. So even if Myanmar offer you 200 years lease, it won't attract. So if Thailand propose for 99 year lease, it might not be attractive for investor as well. It might not be interested for investor either. Why? It is because of the economy or because of politics or something. Not only this generous offers. I think for those foreigners who like to be in Thailand, maybe they like to retire, they like to stay in Thailand, I think 30 year lease is adequate, really adequate. I think like if I were 60 years old, and if I lease my condominiums or my land for 30 years, I think it should be ample amount of time for me to lease, right? Not to be 99 years. I don't think my children, say if I'm an American, I don't think my children will come to get my asset or inheritance in Thailand. So it is not attractive. And I never see any foreign chamber of commerce trying to say that they need to lease land up to 99 years. There is no challenge or no proposition for that. I don't know why our government trying to let foreigners to lease land for 99 years. In the case of condominiums, as you may know, I'm running the largest real estate information center in Thailand. Our real estate information center agency for real estate affairs, we established this information center in 1994, but our company started in 1991. So our real estate database already now 30 years, and we are sure that we are the largest one, and we conduct survey very frequently, every quarter, so we know what are happening in Thailand real estate. And we possess the most comprehensive and most in-depth information. And we found that every year, condominiums in Bangkok, 70% bought by end users. 70%, say two-thirds. And another 20%, 20%, bought by speculators. Speculators bought those condominiums for 20%. And 10% bought by foreigners. So I don't think we need to increase the share of foreigners from 49% to 99%, because there are a large number of condominiums in Bangkok. There might be some condominiums that exceed or meet the maximum 49% already. So maybe they can lease. You need to just let them buy 99, or lease for 99 years, just 30 years should be okay. Maybe they can lease in other condominiums so that can be income distribution or something. So I don't think we need to let them lease for, to increase the share from 49% to 75%. And in addition to the case of land, you may know that not many people in Thailand like to lease land. They just buy it. But for foreigners, they like to lease land. But who will lease land for 99 years? Can you imagine who will lease land for 99 years? It might be large firms from abroad, from big countries. But so sorry, I could not say which country, but should be neighboring countries, really big countries. They may like to lease land. And who will be the suppliers of land? Normally, the big tycoon in Thailand, who may whole land for maybe 1,000 acres of land or 10,000 acres of land. These people, they will be able to lease land. So maybe foreigners, that is big firms, gigantic firms from great countries may come to lease land from these tycoons because they can have a big piece of land to lease. No other supplies with big pieces of land. So they may lease the land for agricultural uses. They may grow durian. They may grow rice. They may grow anything. Or they may build their own town, build their own township to stay in Thailand. It will become something like a colony, something like in China, in Shanghai. In Shanghai, they have a colonial and in the colony, and they said that this is just for foreigners. This can happen in Thailand. But some may argue that if foreigners come into Thailand, maybe our Thai laborers can benefit. Say they may be working from homeworks, gardeners, or some things. But I think they may hide our foreign workers, foreign laborers, like those from Myanmar or Cambodia or something. They may not even hire Thai laborers. So I don't think it should be beneficial for our country. So maybe we have to consider on this. And in the past, you may know that if you know Thailand or Bangkok quite well, you may know that in Thailand, we have Central Lat Phrao, a gigantic mall, a really gigantic mall. Maybe 45 years old already. And this gigantic mall, they lease the land for only 30 years. Don Mueang Tollway, the tollway system, or a mass transit system, they also lease the land or the contract, the concession is only for 30 years only. There are so many high-end residential condominiums also lease the land for 30 years only. There is no need to lease for 99 years. And the investor, they are also happy. You may know Dusitani Hotel, or say they may lease for 30 years or 50 years, not 99 years. They are also happy. That is why the increase of the number of years for the lease from 30 or 50 years to 99 years is very skeptical. What who will be the one who clearly come? Might be big firms from big countries or big countries nearby or something. Another thing is that in the case of condominiums, if we see how many percent, what is the percentage of condominiums owned by foreigners? I found that in the case of Vietnam, they allow only 30%. Thailand, 49%, will increase to 75%. But Vietnam, 30%. In the Philippines, 40%. In Indonesia, 49%, similar to Thailand. In Malaysia, 50%. I don't know why there is a need to increase to 75%. So this is something that we have to question on this. And I think we should, if we really want to allow foreigners to buy or lease properties in Thailand, we have to have strong tax. You may know that in the case of the Philippines, in the case of Singapore, in the case of Singapore, if you buy an apartment or owner-occupied apartments or condominiums there, say $1 million, if you buy it at the price of $1 million, you have to pay tax, buying tax of 600,000, that is 60% of the buying price, of the price. Thailand, we did not levy any tax on this. So how can we boost the economy without any tax from foreigners? Singapore 60%, Hong Kong 30%. In Europe, in European countries, maybe 10 to 20%. But in Thailand, we don't charge anything. This is something we should charge foreigners on this. Second tax that we should charge, say if we buy properties in the US, every year we have to pay property tax, annual property tax. Say annual property tax might be 1% to 3% of the assess value. But the assess value is similar to the market value. So this means that at least they pay tax, say around 1%. If I buy a house in the US worth, $300,000, I have to pay tax, say $3,000 per year, every year. However, in Thailand, we will pay tax if the house, if our house worth above 50 million baht of the assess price. You may know that the assess price in Thailand may be just only 1/3, 1/4 of the market price. So this means that most of the people won't pay any tax. And the tax rate is very, very ridiculous. Say every 1 million baht, you pay tax for 200 baht. Every 1 million baht, you pay tax 200 baht. If you take a taxi from Phuket Airport to the city to pay tax, the airport taxi may be around 700 baht, but you may pay tax 200 baht or 300 baht. Very ridiculous. The tax is very low. So, but if we buy properties in the US, in the UK, we need to pay 1% of the tax in accordance to the market price. So if foreigners come to buy properties here, we should apply the same. But in Thailand, we did not apply that. So this won't be beneficial to our country, right? And in the case of capital gain tax, say my friend buy a house in the US, $1 million, but now it is $2 million already. So I earn $1 million. That $1 million we have to be levied for 20%. So $200,000 must be paid for tax. I earn $800,000. That's fair. The Biden administration may say that they want 50%, that may be too high. But in Thailand, we have property gain tax, but really, really low, because we pay on the amount of the government assess value that is really low, and the tax rate is also really, really low. So this means that we won't pay any tax. So if we allow foreigners to come to buy property in Thailand, we need to tax them similar to when we go to buy properties in UK, in Italy, in Spain, or in Germany, or in the US, in Australia, right? Another tax that we need to tax them, that is inheritance tax or estate tax. You may know that in Japan, if your house worth above 150 million, the amount above 150 million baht, not yen, 150 million baht, you have to pay tax up to 55%, more than half. So this implies that you have to pay a lot of tax. But in Thailand, they said that if your house worth less than 100 million baht of the assess value, as I told you, the assess value might be only 1/3 or 1/4 or 1/5 of the market price. So in this case, you won't pay anything. So if our government allow foreigners to buy properties freely in Thailand, you should apply tax that is an internationally accepted tax to foreigners. We may not apply this for local people. We have a reason, because if we buy property abroad, we have to pay a lot of tax. So if they come to, if foreigners come to buy properties in Thailand, they have to pay an ample amount of tax as well. So this is reasonable, sound enough to tax them, to levy them, okay? In addition, we may imitate Malaysia. Malaysia, they said that if you buy properties in the hub of the cities, you have to pay at least you have to buy at a price above 2 million ringgit. Some may be 1 million ringgit, but standard may be 2 million ringgit. 2 million ringgit is around $500,000. You have to buy a house or a condominium above $500,000. You cannot buy below that. Similarly, in the case of Indonesia, you can buy condominiums, but the price must be above $300,000, roughly $300,000. Why? Because they don't want their fellow countrymen to be competed by foreigners. If foreigners can buy cheap houses for speculation or for rent or something, then the property price, house price will increase because there are demand from abroad. That's why their government care about the benefit of their fellow countrymen. This is a good idea. Another thing is that we have to have some recreation. Say, we may say that if you buy a house or land or anything in Thailand, within the first 3 years, you cannot sell it. You cannot resell it. Within the first 3 years, you cannot resell it. Why? This is to curb speculation. Otherwise, some foreigners may come to buy land and sell, buy and sell for short-term speculation. So this is some measures that we should apply. And no one proposed except me in Thailand. So I try to make it internationally. The last thing I propose to the government, that is the prime ministers, is that if foreigners come to buy properties here, we should allow them to get loan. Say they can get loan up to 50% of the property value. Say if they come to lease land 99 years at around $1 million, or buy a condominium, a house, $1 million, if they want to borrow money from local banks, we should allow them to borrow. But the percentage of the loan must be only no more than 50%, 50%. So that this will also help boost our economy and have some borrowing from abroad into our Thai banks. These are the proposals that I try to propose to the government. And in accordance with my study, we found that if we tax them properly as I propose, every year we will earn around 135 billion baht. Let me calculate for you. 135, thank you. It is around 3,750 million US dollar, 3.75 billion US dollar. We can levy this tax every year. And if we have some pardon for those illegal or gray occupation of properties by foreigners in Thailand. There are some nominee companies or something. If we pardon them and then let them settle down and pay tax in accordance with the regulation that I propose, I think the tax that we can levy every year, it may be over 200 billion baht. Or it should be around 5 billion US dollar. So we have tax to nourish our economy for our fellow countrymen, because in Thailand we can attract a lot of foreigners, particularly in Phuket, in Pattaya, Chiang Mai, Bangkok, and many other cities. I think many people love to stay in Thailand, but we make to make it clear with integrity, and then it would be beneficial to our countries. So this is my proposition to the government. But right now, our Thailand is too free to allow foreigners to buy properties. You may know that they may set up a company, a nominee companies, like a Thai company, but really it is a foreign companies. So this is something in the gray area. Or maybe some other trick to own properties in Thailand. So this is something that we have to make it clean, and also with tax for our country. So I would like to welcome you to be in Thailand, to invest in Thailand, because right now we still have a lot of good regulation for people to buy properties in Thailand. Let me just tell you that in this coming in this coming Friday in this coming July the 5th Friday, we will have a seminar on how to buy properties in Thailand, how to sell properties for foreigners. You can also come to this event. It will be organized at the Anoma Grand Hotel, Bangkok. And another event that we are having is the in-depth analysis of Phuket real estate as of quarter one of 2024. This presentation will be in English, and this is on Wednesday, July the 3rd. Wednesday, July the 3rd, before the National Day of USA, July the 4th. So we have on July the 3rd in Bangkok. You can attend via Zoom, or you can also attend physically yourself at our Thai Real Estate Business School. So you can go to our website, Thai Real Estate Business School. This is to give you information on our latest survey and the most comprehensive survey in Phuket. What happened? So that if you like to invest in Phuket, you should come to this event. We still have many other events in Thailand, in our Thai Real Estate Business School and our agency for real estate affairs. So this is my brief talking on these matters. As Thailand, the freest country for foreign ownership of real estate. If you have any question or something, I can answer to you from this live, and you can also contact me via my Facebook or my WhatsApp or something. So thank you very much for your attention, for your participation for this evening. And now Thailand is almost 9 o'clock in the evening, so it may be at night now, but in New York right now it may be only 8 o'clock in the morning, in the very early morning. So good day to you, and see you later. Thank you very much. สวัสดีครับ. Bye bye.